Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss composite functions. In our example, we have two functions. So let f of x equal x squared plus 1 and g of x equals 3x. We have to find f plus g, f minus g, f times g, f over g, and then the function compositions f og and g of. Let's go ahead and work through all of these very carefully. Solution. Let's start with f plus g. So we have parentheses f plus g, parentheses, and then we have our x. And so the formula for f plus g is basically just adding the functions. So it's really f of x plus g of x. And you can skip this step and just add them, but I want to just show the extra step. So by definition, f plus g of x is equal to f of x plus g of x. Instead of f of x, we just write x squared plus 1. And instead of g of x, we write 3x. And that's pretty much it. However, it's best to write your answers where the exponents are descending. So like you write x squared first, and then you write 3x, and then you write the 1. You see how they get smaller in exponents. So that would be f plus g of x. Pretty simple. Let's do f minus g of x. So parentheses f minus g, and then parentheses, then you have your x in parentheses. And so this is equal to f of x minus g of x. F of x in this case is x squared plus 1. And then g of x is just 3x, so minus 3x. This ends up being x squared minus 3x plus 1. Just a warning here, because the example could have been different. If g has two terms, you really want to put parentheses around the 3x. So just watch out for that. Like if it had been 3x plus 7, then you would have needed the parentheses there because the negative would distribute. So just something to keep in mind about subtraction. Sometimes you need parentheses. If you like, you can just always put them there as a precaution, but it's not necessary. But if you have more than one term, you're going to need those parentheses. Let's look at f times g. We have parentheses f times g of x. The definition is just the product. So it's f of x times g of x. That's f of x times g of x. And this is equal to, well, f of x is x squared plus 1, so we have parentheses x squared plus 1. And then g of x is 3x. This is times 3x. Now we can actually perform the multiplication, just like distribute to 3x. The 3x times x squared, well, there's a 1 here on the exponent, so you add it, you're going to get 3x. That's a really weird 3. Let me try to redraw that. So 3x cubed, and 3x times 1 is 3x, the 3x. Boom. And that would be f times g of x. So again, you just multiply 3x times your x squared plus 1. All right, now we have f over g of x. So f over g of x. And this is just dividing, so the definition is just f of x over g of x. So all you do is divide here. And again, you can skip the formulas, but I think it's really good to write them down. This stuff comes up later. If you study more mathematics, you do stuff like this, so it's good. I think it's good. F of x is x squared plus 1. And g of x is 3x. And that's pretty much it, right? You can't really do anything there. You can break it up, but let's just leave it. Looks pretty good to me. All right, now we've reached the harder part, FOG. Let's do it. I'm going to scroll down a little bit to make sure you can see okay. So I'm going to switch to blue, change up the color. So we have FOG. It's FOG of X. That's how you read it. It's FOG of X. And this is equal to, by definition, f of g of x. It's weird. You say O when you see the O, but when you see the parentheses, you say of. So it's FOG of X is equal to F of G of X. It's kind of a interesting pronunciation thing. So you replace the inside piece first. So G of X is 3X. So you replace that piece. It's F of 3X. And then your F of X is X squared plus 1. So basically, your X is 3X. So instead of X squared, it's just 3X squared. So parentheses 3X squared plus 1. And when you square the 3X, you basically just square the 3 and square the X. So squaring the 3, you get 9. Squaring the X, you get X squared. So you just get 9X squared plus 1. That would be FOG of X. And lastly, we have GOF. Let's do that one. We have GOF of X. This is equal to G of F of X. Pretty easy to memorize. It's just the order you see it, right? FOG of X is F of G of X. GOF of X is G of F of X. So you see GF, GF, FG, FG. So it's pretty easy to memorize the definition. Then you always replace the inside piece first. It's G of, well, F is X squared plus 1, so we'll put that there. And then now we look at G. So G is 3X, right? So this is our X. This whole thing, this X squared plus 1 is our X. What we're plugging in. So it's 3 times all of this. So 3 parentheses, X squared plus 1. And then we distribute to 3. 3 times X squared is 3X squared. And 3 times 1 is 3. Pretty cool. Yeah, it's a lot of examples. So we did the sum, difference, product, quotient, and the composition in both orders. So yeah, pretty cool things you can do with functions in mathematics. Hopefully you've learned some math in this video. If you feel you have, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.